again, everyone. I'm sorry if you can't hear me, but I've been losing my voice because I've been coughing all day. I'll try to keep it up, and I'm sorry that if you couldn't hear me last video, but it turns out that even though I have a really nice new Yeti microphone, there, I just tapped it a little bit. That if I still lean too far back, then you guys won't be able to hear me as well. This is gonna be horrible. This might be a shorter video because of my lost voice. But, yeah, the reason I'm starting at the start screen is because, as you can see, the face here has opened up a little bit. And I thought that was kind of interesting. You'll get to see me load in and continue the game. Oh, okay. I guess when I complete a chapter, depending on what happens, I can, it won't let me go back. Which is a shame, because I wanted to go back, because the TARDIS showed me the rest of the chapter. I stopped at the end. And apparently there was another way that we could have gotten up into the comm center without putting Carl through unending pain. But oh well, that was my stupid choice. My stupid, stupid, uninformed choice. But that's the danger of blind Let's Plays. Or relatively blind Let's Plays, is what's happening here. I hope you can see me, because I have to lean forward to get close to the mic. My face is in danger of going off screen. Oh man, I don't have my lamp. She's off on my bed. Oh god. Thank you. least we have our little robot buddy to help us. Let me try going around the other way. It'll probably be considerably more dangerous since I don't have any cover. Oh wait, I do! Well, I'm gonna hang back for a bit since there seems to be some cover, I will at least make my way that way. Sometimes. I'd enjoy it if you just paused. Okay, it's going to the ship. And now it's going away from the ship. What the hell is that? I was wondering what that was. I don't know what it is. It looks like more of those space barnacles. That space barnacle plus structure gel combo. Oh god. Oh.
Thank you. Let's hope the shuttle's still working.
Yes, let's hope it will. Problem is that I am quite worried. Oh, okay.
Where did I get a flashlight?
I have a flashlight. Oh dear. Can't speak. Losing voice. Simon can tolerate the dark, unlike one Mr. Daniel. I'm pretty much gonna stick around in the dark up. There's probably stuff that can detect me if I've got my light on. I mean, the first robot we encountered was all like, I'm just patrolling, I'm gonna not do anything till I see you. But the other one we just met was one that could hear you. Interestingly enough, not sure what sort of sensory mechanism it has to be able to hear. And there's probably, and given that there's such a variety of robots, there's probably one that easily detects me if I've got my flashlight shining in its face. So let's see what the data buffer has to say.
Tracky, come in, Theta. What? I can't.
Where are you now?
Tracky, I'm at the shuttle, but it's not looking good. The lights flicker like mad. I think the power regulator is broken. I have to fix it. I don't want to get stranded halfway to Theta. What was that? I can't hear you. Don't worry. I'll fix it. Somehow.
All right. So it seems that the shuttles are busted. Impact event. close crest into the position of an impact ranks as one of the largest collisions ever recorded on Earth.
Ooh. Well.
Indicate surface has gone completely barren and is no longer to sustain life.
Oh my god.
What? I don't remember the years. It's like, what is this, about 100 years into the future? At most, I think. I'd have to go back and look at my last video to see if they have the years printed on the data thing that I looked at. There's a video. Ooh.
I guess it's a good thing we never had any kids. Hard enough looking my parents in the eyes. They're going to a bomb shelter upstate, by the way, along with your dad. I'm guessing someone will help him send you a message somehow. I mean, I hope they will. Hell, I'm not even sure you'll get this message. If you do, I want you to know I never blamed you for following your dreams. I was just mad it didn't fit better with what I imagined our lives would be. I really wanted the picket fence, big family, you know? I guess what I'm trying to say is I'm proud of you. And even though it's been difficult to be separated from you, I regret nothing. I'm happy. And I really wish I was able to say this without the sky falling down. I love you, Amy. I always have. And always will.
Aww. How sad. Let me take a look at that manifest again. Okay. I guess that's it. I think I'll pause here.